Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I am going to be talking about the 5 reasons why you can't lose weight. So for anyone brand new on my channel, I used to be 60 pounds heavier than I am right now, which I know doesn't seem like a lot, but I am a short 5'2". So 60 pounds on my body is a lot more than 60 pounds in like a 6-foot person, you know what I mean? I learned from trial and error, and I thought that you guys should know these tips too. It can be super duper frustrating if you are trying to lose weight and better yourself, but you believe one thing that's actually not true, and it's actually causing you to not lose weight. So I'll kind of share with you guys the reasons I kind of notice in other people why they can't lose weight, and also how I used to be way back then. And then I will kind of share with you how to fix that so you can too. So number one is you believe in diets. Every time someone says they want to lose weight, they're like, oh, I'm going on a diet tomorrow. I gotta go on this juice cleanse. Oh, I think I'm gonna do the keto diet, the Atkins diet. It does actually make you lose weight. Sorry if the lighting's like kind of weird in here. But once you go off your diet, what happens then? You're gonna lose the weight back because you didn't change anything about your lifestyle. So my mom growing up always made the cabbage soup. It's like a diet where you're supposed to eat cabbage soup for like 7 days. Obviously you're gonna lose weight because you're literally just drinking water with cabbage and some beef or whatever. I don't know what they put in there. Your body is a reflection of all of the choices you make every single day. So if you choose to drink pop rather than water, if you choose to have fast food for lunch rather than a homemade meal, all of these choices really lead to your body. That's why models and athletes look the way they do, because they make completely different choices than the average Joe every single day. Like, they wake up at like fucking 4 a.m. You know, by the time it's 7 a.m., they've already did like 2-hour workouts or some crazy stuff like that. So if you want your body to look a certain way, or you want to lose weight, you're gonna have to change something in your life. If you think doing a juice cleanse or cutting out carbs, cutting out fats, doing like a really restrictive one is gonna make you lose weight, you're right, but it's not going to stay off. You're gonna gain the weight back. I also wanted to tie this in with counting calories because, you know, it's the same thing kind of. But a lot of people ask me if I ever counted calories, and the answer to that is no, because I think if you count calories, you just become so obsessed with food. Like, you'll literally be looking at something and be like, okay, this is 500 calories, this apple is 200 calories, oh my god, I can't have these together because I'm gonna go over my calorie intake, and just chill. So my tip to fix this is just eat healthy, choose healthy options, include fats, don't cut out fats or anything, have carbs, have protein, fiber, and the slower you kind of lose weight, then the longer it'll stay off. So, like, it took me a full year to lose 60 pounds, so that's the reason why I've been able to keep it off, because I just implemented those healthy habits and lifestyle choices to keep the weight off. So number two is the belief that going to the gym is gonna help you lose weight. How many of you guys have said, oh man, I gotta lose weight, I'm gonna join the gym next week? Me too. I say that all the time, but I have to remember, it's not gonna help me lose weight. It's like a combination of things. I often see people get super duper frustrated because they go to the gym all the time, they work out, they're getting fit, but they're not losing weight and their body's not changing. I mean, I don't know if it's scientifically proven or not, but from what I have experienced, it's not really anything to do with exercise. It's really mostly to do with what you eat, because if you're going to the gym and you're still having McDonald's afterwards and pop, it's not really doing much for you. I was devastated when I found out I had to eat healthy to lose weight. And I didn't even want to lose weight at first because I was like, ugh, I'd rather not be skinny if that means I can't eat McDonald's every day. Once you actually get into eating healthy, like, it doesn't taste bad. Like, it tastes really freaking good. Like, I recommend if you're going to eat healthy, cook and become good at cooking, and it just tastes amazing. And also, if you cook a lot at home and you have McDonald's, then you really appreciate the McDonald's when you have it, so it's actually a treat. Me right now, I eat very healthy. I'm petite, but flabby at the same time. There's no muscle. You definitely want to do both of them because it's just gonna make you look so good. Like, imagine eating really healthy and working out. Oh my god, you'd look amazing. I really wish I had the motivation to work out. I just don't. That's my New Year's resolution, is to work out more. Number three is you skip meals. No. You don't want to do that. I know it can be kind of tempting to starve yourself because you think that by eating food, you're going to gain weight, but it's actually the opposite. If you do not eat, your body will cling to any food that you give it afterwards, which will result in you gaining more weight, which is gonna result in you not eating as much, and then you're gonna gain more weight, and then you're gonna be like, oh my god, I'm not gonna eat anything at all, and then your body's gonna be like, what the fuck? So you have to make sure you eat like 3 meals a day, breakfast, lunch, dinner. If you're hungry in between, have some snacks, but don't starve yourself. So number four is drinking your calories. So the reason why I find a lot of people can't lose weight is because they're eating super healthy, they're going to the gym, but do you stop to realize how many extra calories you have when you drink orange juice or you have apple juice or some pop, smoothies after the gym? Like, it really, really adds up. So let's just pretend these are oranges, because no one would freaking drink banana juice. I don't even know that exists. Okay, maybe a banana smoothie. It is healthy to eat banana. It's natural sugars, it has fiber, and eating this will probably not make you full. Maybe eating two will make you feel like not as hungry. Anyways, this isn't bad for you, right? But when you have a smoothie, sorry, my water's in here, you are having like quadruple that. So you're having like 5 or 6 or 7 bananas, and that's a lot of sugar. Pop as well, there are so many calories in pop. When I was struggling with my weight before, I used to drink Coke Slurpees all the time. Like, oh, the lighting's kind of weird, sorry. I used to drink Coke Slurpees all the time. Every single day, to school, at lunchtime, like I bought a big Coke Slurpee from 7-Eleven. Then after school, I'd have another big Coke Slurpee. I remember I dropped like 10 pounds so quickly when I stopped drinking it, because you just don't even realize how much sugar or calories are in one thing of Coke. Number five is you believe foods are healthy when they're really not. So this is one thing that I was shocked by. I guess they aren't technically lying, because when things say like reduced fat, sugar free, you instantly think it's healthier and it's better than the regular option. That's marketing for you, okay? This is a billion freaking dollar industry, and whenever they say fat free, sugar free, usually that means they're adding something else to substitute to make it still taste as good as the original stuff. So I mean, if it says fat free, they might be adding more sugar. If it says sugar free, they might be adding some more fat. So as well as gluten free, organic, vegan, what else? Vegetarian. Chocolate gluten-free cookies are still chocolate cookies. Vegan, what do I want to say? Vegan Pop-Tarts are still Pop-Tarts. I don't even know if that's a thing. Brown bread, be careful when you read the package. Sometimes it actually says white bread mixed with a little bit of whole grain to make it look brown. And protein bars. A lot of protein bars actually aren't healthy for you. They have a lot of sugar. They're usually coated in chocolate to make them taste better. And also sugar-free Diet Cokes and stuff like that, they are not good for you. Pretty sure everyone already knows this by now, but sugar-free or Diet Coke, the substitute that they use is linked to stuff like obesity, high blood sugar, what else? Diabetes, so be really, really careful. Don't just be like, nah, I'm just gonna substitute my Cokes every day for Diet Cokes. It's not healthy for you. I mean, you might actually lose weight because it might actually have less sugar, but still not healthy. Number six is you never let yourself indulge. When I was losing weight, I set aside a day every single week where I would have whatever I wanted. So that doesn't mean that I would eat everything I want the whole day, but that means maybe for dinner I would have my favorite takeaway, or maybe at lunchtime I'd have like a Coke Slurpee or something. Something that I really liked. It actually helped me, because when I was spending the whole week exercising and eating really healthy, and it was really difficult to get myself eating healthy after the diet that I kind of had. But because I gave myself like that cheat meal to look forward to every week where I could eat whatever I wanted, it actually motivated me. And I just find too, like, when you don't let yourself indulge, so say like instead of eating regular cookies, you get like the really, really healthy kind, just eat the damn normal cookies, but just don't eat them as much. As well as too, like, don't be that person that goes to like a party or like holiday dinner or something and you won't let yourself eat, slice a cake. Just eat the damn cake, girl. Like, life is too short. Like, don't limit yourself so much. I told myself, like, if I had to give things up like that, like, if I couldn't go to a party and have a drink or two, if I couldn't go out with my friends for a burger, even though it wasn't my cheat meal, like, you know, if I didn't do things sometimes, and I always just was so restrictive, I feel like my weight loss wouldn't have been as successful. One tip that I have for you guys is if you are struggling with the whole healthy eating and moderation, like a long time ago, I was watching this interview with Miranda Kerr where she said she has like an 80-20 rule. So 80% of the time she eats super healthy and then 20% of the time she eats whatever she wants. Make sure your health level is here and then yeah, you can indulge and enjoy yourself sometimes, but just make sure it's not like 50-50 or this way. You want to make sure it's like 80-20. That was my 5 tips on how to combat the 5 reasons I find most people don't lose weight. Obviously, take what I'm saying with a grain of salt because I'm not a dietitian. I don't know anything really. This is just my experience and what I kind of observed in other people as well as like myself. So yeah, that was the end of the video. I hope that my tips were really helpful for you guys. If you guys want to see more of my videos, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. The little link is down below. If you guys want to as well, there's a big lack between my Instagram followers and my YouTube subscribers. So if you haven't followed me on Instagram, go follow me at Megan Margot. I actually started to post there, which is crazy because before I never really posted there. So go there if you want to see some cool photos. Okay. But anyways, I just want to thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you in my next video.